Hey there guys, how's it going? Welcome back to the channel. Today we're gonna have a bit of a different video. We'll be talking about how you can be the most productive while doing online learning. You know the situation, it's 2020, things are not going that great and you're probably having all your classes online. And that in itself brings a lot more challenges than you'd normally expect. So I'm gonna give you 5 tips on how you can up your productivity while you do online learning. So the first one is your timetable. Now, in anything you do always, you need to have time allocated and you know what time you're going to use for what activities. If you don't, you're just going to end up lousing around. Now, probably you already have your school timetable and whatnot. Now, there are a bunch of timetable apps out there, but I've kind of find all of them are basically calendar apps with reminders and nothing really special. So instead of you going out there and installing a third party app, you could use Google Calendar. And I'll show you how you can make Google Calendar work for you as perfectly as possible when doing online learning. First, you go to calendar.google.com. You create a new calendar, give it a name, something along the lines of class schedule, and then you can start adding events to that calendar. Go back and forth between your timetable and the calendar app and add all the events. Make sure they are recurring, weekly, bi-weekly, whatever your schedule looks like, and set the reminder for at least 30 minutes. With online learning, you want to give yourself a bit more room for any eventualities in case there's technical glitches and whatnot. Then you also have the option to add the meeting links to your calendar. Now, mind you, because this is a Google app, you're not going to be able to put just any meeting link, say from Zoom or Skype or whatever. It's only Google Meet links, but you can still put other links in the description, in your event description. And the best thing about this one is you can share your calendar with, say, a classmate. You know, you just share it with them and they'll be able to use the same calendar. Now, after you've done all that, you want to go to your phone and change your notification settings. Normally, calendar notifications are silent ones. You want to make them ring and give you an alert for when it's going to happen. So just make sure you do that as well. Another benefit to using the Google Calendar is you get to see all your tasks. So in your to-do list or your tasks. Other to-do lists and tasks apps are great, but then I find there's a bit more harmony when you use one suite of apps. So whatever you put in the Google Tasks app will show up in your calendar, and that way you get a quick glimpse of exactly what you need to do. And I use the Tasks app to remind myself to do assignments, some research, or set aside time for studying. That way I never miss a thing and procrastination doesn't creep in. The next thing we're going to talk about is distractions. Now, there are always going to be distractions in any class, no matter what. But because you're at home, your home is a place where you go to relax, rest, and, you know, recreate. So it's perfectly set up for relaxing, and yet you're trying to be productive. Now, your parents might have found a good balance with this, but it's a bit tougher for you as a student. So what I do is make sure the room you're studying in doesn't have a TV, or if you can't have another room for studying, make sure the TV is off whenever you're studying. Secondly, you want to close all distractions from your computer. So just go ahead and close all other browser tabs that you don't need, that are not school related. You can open them later on, and just have the ones that will help you learn open. It's really easy to, as the lecture is going on in the background, just flip through YouTube, Twitter, or whatever. I mean, you already do this in a physical class, but it's way easier to do this while learning online. You also want to set your phone to do not disturb mode for the times when you have your classes. And finally, you want to write on pen and paper. This is a really great way to keep distractions at a minimum. As you're going through your class, instead of just sitting back and watching, you're going to find yourself looking for something to do with your hands. So I find it best to just have a pen and paper and note down whatever is happening in the lecture. That way you learn a bit more and you keep the distractions to a minimum. Okay, tip number three, file system. You're probably going to have a lot of files, presentations, notes, PDFs, whatever it is, sent to you by multiple teachers. What you want to do is have a clear file system to make it as easy as possible for you to find whatever you're looking for. So my file system is pretty simple. This is by no means the best way to do it, but this is just how I do it. I have a folder on my desktop called class, and in that folder there's the subfolders for different school years. So year one and year two have their own folders, and then inside those folders I have the semesters, so semester one or semester two, and then inside those semesters I have the individual subjects or courses, because each semester you might have different subjects you're studying. So in those folders is where I keep all my files. So when I know I need, say, notes from lecture one, I know where to go and find it immediately. I don't need to dig through my downloads folder or anything like that. I just know where to go. I also store my coursework and assignments there. So I also know where to go to find each and every single thing. You'll find when it comes to naming these things, it's easy to be repetitive. So assignment one, you can have 10 assignment ones. But if they're in the individual folders, you can know for which subject it is. All right, tip number four, updates and class groups. You want to be in all these groups as much as possible, depending on what messaging apps you use, Telegram, WhatsApp, or whatever it is. Just make sure you're in all the groups that are relevant to your class. You don't want to miss a thing. I know it can get a bit noisy with people, you know, chatting a lot of pretty much nonsense, but you want to be in all those groups so that you don't miss a thing. And the fifth and final tip is lecture or class recordings. So with online learning, there's a lot of things that can go wrong, and a lot of times they do go wrong. You know, your network gets jumpy or whatever the case is. You always want something to fall back on. And also the fact that your lecturer is, or your teacher is, not with you physically to explain some of the things all the time. It's really good if you have a recording to go and rewatch. So always request your lecturers to record the sessions, and then they could upload them as an unlisted video on YouTube or whatever, so you know where to go to find those recordings. It also saves them a lot of headache, because they're probably dealing with a lot of classes with a lot of students, so this I'm sure they will appreciate. But if your lecturer doesn't want to record, or for whatever reason they can't record, there's no reason to stop you from recording. So if you can use a screen recorder app, there are a lot of them out there. I personally use OBS, and each time there's a lecture, you just set up your scene, choose the meeting window, and set that to be recorded, and record desktop audio as well. So just hit record before every lecture. At the end of it all, if you zoned out for a bit, you can go back and rewind that way. And finally, if you have a friend or few friends that are not showing up for lectures, please do, you know, remind them to join in, because at the end of it all, you're still going to be graded like as if it were a normal school season, yet it wasn't, and people are going through different things. So just make sure you check in on them and ask them why they aren't joining. You could also, you know, share with them this video and see if it helps them. I'm sure they'll appreciate it. But that's been it. Thank you very much for watching. If you liked this video, if you found it helpful, please consider subscribing and hitting that like button. It really does help. Also, don't forget to turn on the notification bell so that you don't miss when I post a new video. And I will see you in the next one.